Hello dear students, in last lecture we have discussed about the germ theory of disease and how direct evidence and indirect evidence given by the different contributors so that to support the germ theory of disease. So in this lecture, last lecture we have also discussed about the postulates given by the Robert Koch, their limitations as well. So in this lecture we will discuss about the, apart from that, what are the major contribution of Robert Koch in the field of microbiology. Robert Koch investigated the anthrax disease cycle in 1876. He also studied the bacteria called tuberculosis in 1882 and cholera disease related study in 1883. In the same time, or you can say when carried out this study, he discovered the bacteria which is anthrax bacilli, which cause anthrax disease, tubercle bacilli, which cause tuberculosis, and cholera, that is Vibrio cholera, which cause a cholera. So he discovered these bacteria are responsible to carry out same type of this type of diseases. Koch also observed the phenomenon of acquired immunity. While discussing about the immunity, we will discuss about the passive immunity and acquired immunity. So there are phenomenon about acquired immunity are given by the Robert Koch. He introduced solid media with the use of agar as solidifying agent. He developed pore plate method. In microbiology lab, while preparing the media, we use solid media as agar media, you can say, or in case of liquid media, you can say broth media. To solidify that media, we use the solidifying agent as agar-agar powder, and it is extracted from the seaweed algae, seaweed. So he used that agar-agar powder as a solidifying agent, and he also developed a pore plate method for the isolation of pure culture of bacteria. In the next paper we will also discuss about the different methods of pure culture isolation. So in that, pore plate method has described or given by the Robert Koch. Koch also developed media suitable for for growing bacteria isolated from the body. The result was development of nutrient broth and nutrient agar media, still in wide use today. The media which has developed or described by the Robert Koch, nutrient broth and nutrient agar, these are the basic media normally used in nowadays for the culturing different types of organisms or for isolation of different organisms. So these are the common media. Nowadays we can also use this media. These are the basic media. He also introduced method for isolation of bacteria in pure culture. Here we have already discussed. He also developed a method for isolation of pure culture of bacteria. He described hanging rope method for testing motility. Hanging rope method is nothing but a method used for the determining the whether organism is motile or non-motile. With this, cavity slide is used and cover slip is attached or cover slip is placed over the cavity and observe under the microscope to determine whether that bacteria are motile or non-motile. So it is nothing but a hanging rope method, which is also given by the Sir Robert Koch. He invented the hot air oven steam sterilizer and also introduced method to find out the efficacy of antiseptics. Apart from this contribution, he also developed a hot air oven, that is dry sterilizer. You can also use this instrument nowadays in all microbiological laboratory. Steam sterilizer, by using steam, how we can sterilize particular instrument or in say clocks, nothing but a dry moist sterilizer related to autoclave. He also introduced that type of mechanism, and also he introduced method to find out the efficacy of antiseptics, how antiseptics are effective against different microorganisms to avoid to growth or to sterilize the particular instrument or can say tabletop, how that antiseptics are effective against different microorganisms. So in this way, Robert Koch carried out a major contribution in the field of microbiology. After that, Charles Chamberlain, he discovered or contributed in the field of virology. Discovery of viruses and their role in diseases was made possible with Charles Chamberlain and constructed a porcelain bacteriological filter. Charles Chamberlain, when he invented porcelain bacteriological filter, which is helpful for the isolation or to study the viral structure or viral characteristics. So in that way, viral diseases we can also study using these different filters developed by the Chamberlain, Charles Chamberlain. In this chart, we can see different pathogens and their disease caused by this pathogen. Here, anthrax is a gain of positive region, which was cancer is caused by the Bacillus anthracis. Gonorrhea, it is caused by the Neisseria gonorrhoeae. Typhoid fever, it is caused by the Salmonella typhi. In Marathi, you can say it is as a Vishamjwara. Tuberculosis, that is Kshay Rog, it is caused by the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Cholera, it is caused by the Vibrio cholera. Diphtheria, in Marathi is called as Gata Sarpa, it is caused by the Cornebacterium diphtheria, it is nothing but positive agent of diphtheria. Tetanus, nothing but a Gata Sarpa, it is caused by the Clostridium tetani. Pneumonia, it is caused by the Diplococcus pneumonia, it is a positive agent. Meningitis, it is caused by the Neisserian meningitis. Plague is caused by the Yersinia pestis. Botulism, annavish bada jala mundu, it is caused by the Clostridium botulinum. Dysentery, it is caused by the Shigella dysentery, positive agent. Syphilis, it is caused by the Treponema pallida. And whooping cough, it is caused by the Bordetella pertussis. So these positive agents and all the different types of diseases they have already studied in that field. Now we will discuss about the discovery of microbial effect on organic and inorganic matter. How microorganisms affect organic and inorganic matter, and by their metabolic processes, how they affect the organic or inorganic or cycling. In this way, we can discuss. The two of the pioneers, Winogradsky and Bejerink, made many contribution in the field of soil microbiology. Soil microbiology is a branch of microbiology which deals with the microorganisms which were useful for the soil fertility, or they carried out their different metabolic processes so that they can helpful or sometimes harmful for the crop plant. So all these studies are carried out in soil microbiology. So here two contributors, that is Winogradsky and Bejerink, they have carried out the pioneer works in the field of soil microbiology. Bejerink and Winogradsky investigated biochemical role bacteria play in important natural processes. He investigated the role of microorganisms in different biochemical processes like nitrification, nitrogen fixation and sulfur oxidation. These are the processes which are normally carried out in the environment. Nitrification, nitrogen fixation and sulfur oxidation. On all these processes, microorganisms play an important role. So all these processes investigated by this organism. They discovered the bacteria which can oxidize iron, sulfur and ammonia to obtain energy and mini bacteria that could incorporate carbon dioxide into organic matter like photosynthetic organisms. They also investigated some bacteria which carried out the oxidation of iron, sulfur and ammonia. Apart from that, also they have investigated some bacteria which incorporate carbon dioxide in the organic matter like photosynthesis. That means they are photosynthetic organisms. They have also investigated whether Winogradsky and Bejerink. Iron oxidizing bacteria are non-harmful bacteria that produce their energy by oxidizing the iron Fe2 plus Fe3 plus, that is naturally present in some soils. So they are nothing but an iron oxidizing bacteria. They carried out the oxidation of iron to Fe2 plus Fe3 plus ions. So contribution of Bejerink and Winogradsky are also in the field of these oxidation processes. The common sulfur oxidizing bacteria, that is Thiobacillus thioxidans, is a chemolipotrop utilizing thiosulfate and sulfide as a source of energy to produce sulfuric acid. They are nothing but organisms which carry out chemical energy or by oxidizing some inorganic molecule, and they carry out the process. So they are categorized on the basis of different organotrop, chemoorganotrop. Okay. So on this way, the sulfur oxidizing bacteria, that is thiobacillus thioxidans, have also studied by these scientists. Microorganism accomplished a major element, that is transformation in the way of mineralization and immobilization in soil. Microorganism, apart from oxidation, they are also carried out the process, that is mineralization and immobilization of minerals in soil. They convert the complex organic nutrient into simple organic compound are called as mineralization. That means they carried out the breakdown of complex organic molecule into simpler form, and that process is called as mineralization, and it is carried out by the help of these microorganisms which are present in the soil. So that plant can make use of this nutrient, and these microbes absorb the simple minerals, that is immobilization, and prevent them from leaching out, and thus conserve the essential nutrient in the soil. So after carrying the process of mineralization, these minerals which are in the simple form are now available to carry out metabolic process of plants, and plant absorb these minerals from the soil, and that process is nothing but a immobilization. And in this way, microorganisms are helpful for the proper nourishment and growth of these plants. So in this way, they are also prevent the leaching of these minerals from the soil. So that when they die and become a part of the organic matter, these essential nutrients are once again mineralized by the microorganism for the plant. This is a cyclic process, mineralization and immobilization. When these organic substances accumulated in the plant and they carried out their complete life cycle, and after the end of their life cycle, these plants get died. And if they now ready or go to the process of decomposition, and this decomposition process is also carried out by the microorganisms, and in this way, these accumulated minerals in the plant body now available in the soil to absorb newly growing plants. So in this way, cyclic mineralization or cyclic process of minerals is carried out, or in this process, microorganisms play an important role in this mineralization and immobilization process. So in this way, these microorganisms are involved in the process of these organic and inorganic molecules to carry out their conversion into simple form, simple to complex form. So in this way, these microorganisms are in side way, we can say they are helpful to guide out these different processes which are normally present in the environment.